Greetings, viewers. Eric the Car Guy here with my new girlfriend. She's all dressed up and ready for prom now. She'll start out in jeans and a t-shirt at the beginning of this video, but we will eventually get to this point. I'll be covering the installation of these aluminum valve covers and why I chose them. Also the rerouting of the ignition wires, but most of all, we'll be covering the installation of the accessories and this accessory kit that I got from CVF Racing, which I'll link down in the description. It was a solution that I needed to mount the AC compressor because when this video started, at that time I had given up on the idea of running AC, but by the time it's all done, well, you see how it ends. So get to watching, check it out. The main reason that I wanted to go with the new valve covers was not because I didn't like the old valve covers, but because they were spitting oil all over the place on the dynamometer. I don't want to fill my engine compartment with oil. I want my oil to stay in my engine. So I went for these breathers on this valve cover, which seems to be the solution. There's also a giant baffle underneath it. Now these are aluminum valve covers. They're not chrome. I'm honestly not a fan of chrome. Chrome is an insulator and it holds in heat. Aluminum is just the opposite. It's lightweight and dissipates heat. But it's a real pain in the butt to work with because any little scratch or ding, that will show up. That sucks. Really sad to lose these valve covers, and I know cameraman Brian is too. We worked pretty hard on getting these painted. Ta-da! Oh, that's beautiful. I know we really never got the opportunity to see this stuff up close and personal. I didn't either. We only scheduled 3 days for the engine shoot, and unfortunately it took more than that. These are the roller rockers from Comp Cams. They're not aluminum, they're steel. Although, if I were to go back and do this again, you know what I might want? A shaft rocker setup. They're just held down better and I think would hold up better, and maybe I'll move for that at some point. Now these valve cover gaskets are pretty much glued onto the valve cover. So I'm just gonna leave them on here. They're perfectly good gaskets. They'll work again on something else. I've already ordered a set of new ones. Got my new gaskets. These are rubberized with metal reinforcement. I'm not gonna use any sealer, anything on them. I'm just gonna install them dry, just like that. Gonna use calibrated torque wrench hand for this. Just gonna snug everything down. I'm not gonna torque the snot out of it. I can't begin to describe my unnatural love for this. Let's just take a moment to admire it. Right. I also went through and rerouted the ignition wires. During the dyno run, we'd switched them around a few times. They've gotten a bit dirty, so they were kind of letting it all down. So I took the opportunity to clean those up and put all the looms and everything back on so it was all pretty and ready to go. Now the accessories and the installation of that was not without its challenges. Number one being, I really wasn't happy about the fact that I had to reuse the fasteners for the water pump pulley. Also, the water pump pulley was not lined up quite correctly with the belts, and I had to go back in and shim. In fact, there's two washers in between the front of the water pump and the back side of this pulley right now in each one of these fasteners. That seemed to be the correct spacing, and it worked out for me, and I'm kind of happy about that. The alternator is what we started with, and that had a fan that came with it, but it was for a different style alternator. I didn't end up using it, but it was nice that it came in the kit in case I did have that type of alternator. This is an aftermarket alternator that I got. It's 130 amp. The alternators that come stock with 5-liter Mustangs aren't known to be the greatest. In fact, I think they're like 60, maybe 70 amps. They're kind of weak. And since I'm running air conditioning and electric fans, I figured it would be a good idea to definitely beef up the amperage in the electrical system, hence the reason we got the bigger alternator. But that did cause some fitment problems, namely with this bracket. The bracket that came with this kit was too thick, and it was coming into contact with the alternator whenever I tried to mount it. So I went back to the mount that you see here, which came with my turbo kit, because we had to remount the alternator because of the turbo and its positioning of this downpipe here. So that wasn't really a big deal. Everything else worked, but I did have to do some adjustments there. The pulley, however, went straight on, so that was nice. The crank pulley, when installing these, I would recommend taping the sockets, unless you use a T-handle or something that's not gonna touch the sides. All I had at the time was a socket, and I was concerned about scratching the surface. Remember I said aluminum is very unforgiving when it comes to things like that? It was also interesting to find out that this pulley was larger than the underdrive pulley that was on here. So I don't know if this is the stock 5 liter size, because when I got my engine, it already had the underdrive pulley on it. So this may be more closer to the normal size, and I'm okay with that, because I plan to drive this car on the street. It's not going to be 100% race. I know looking at this engine, it's kind of hard to see that, but believe me, I'll be driving it on the street. Hence the reason I wanted to go with power steering. At one time, I was just going to go with manual steering on this car. I decided at some point to go with power steering, and in the process got a new power steering pump and got the power steering rack and everything, and then discovered that in order to use this kit, I had to change the power steering pump and go to this Saginaw unit that they have. And honestly, I consider this an upgrade, because the forums and everything and the research that I did showed that not a lot of people are happy with the Ford power steering pump, so this Saginaw is a popular changeover. And I purchased this through CVF Racing along with this kit. It was a separate purchase. I called them up and found out that I also needed to change out the valving in the back of the pump so that I had the correct pressure. So I had to swap out a couple of components. No big deal. CVF Racing had everything I needed. I bought this kit. They didn't give me this kit or anything. I'm not just flat out endorsing them. This was the solution that I needed to mount the AC. The bracketing on the power steering was a little tricky, trying to get that worked out, mainly with the bushings. And then there's a couple of washers underneath here that I needed to install. But once everything got in there, it's in there. It works fine. But in order to mount that, I needed to change the routing of the oil pressure feed for the turbo, because that was going straight up against the side of the block. That was going to come into contact with this new bracket for the AC. I couldn't have that. But once I got the power steering all mounted up and the pulley on there, which I like this pulley better. If you're wondering why I was just able to pull that off in the video, it's because I'll post the link in the description to a premium member video I did about the installation of that new power steering pump and the attempted installation of the air conditioning, all about measuring belts and all that kind of thing. But I like this better, because this one just slides on and off the end of the power steering pump, whereas the Ford pump, you have to press the pulley on and off. Now mine just slides off because that was the pulley off of the Mustang. It was all damaged. I decided to use it as a mock-up pulley, so I just hollowed out the inside of it so that I could just slide it on and off the power steering pump, because all the attachments for the power steering pump were behind that pulley and I didn't want to have to mess with pressing it on and off. So I made myself a mock-up pulley out of the junk pulley I had. I had another pulley that I was going to use to press on if I was going to go with that setup, but I did not, as you can see here. After we got the power steering mounted, or after I got the power steering mounted, I went and mounted the air conditioning, which could not have been easier. I mean, this bracket down here and a through bolt pretty much does it, and this turnbuckle up here locates it and helps adjust some belt tension. Before I installed it, I wanted to put the high and low pressure ports on the back. Make sure that I got that done, which I did. Lastly was the tensioner pulley, which what I ran into here was the fasteners were too long. So I had to go and cut these fasteners down. And several times in the past, I've cut fasteners, and viewers have commented that the best way to do that is to run a nut down over the fastener before you make the cut, so you can, when you run the nut off, it helps clean up the threads on the way off. Well, I tried that technique this time and it did work. However, I still had to go back over to the bench grinder and taper the end of the fastener. And I often do this so that the threads start easier. So no matter what, I went back and did what I always do anyway, but I tried it your way. And I'm not saying that's a bad way. What I'm saying is I ended up going back and doing the exact same thing that I always do anyway, just to get the fasteners to start. A little disappointed that CVF Racing did not give the correct size fasteners. Even more disappointed that they didn't include some kind of water pump fastener, one that had some kind of pretty something going on here, because they did it here, here, and here, but nothing on the water pump. Yeah, you know, I can live with that, but it is what it is. One regret, though, with this pulley is that I didn't tighten down the AC first, which is a little tricky because the fastener for this is right above this pulley and you can't quite get to it, so I had to get a little creative. There's also the Nylock nut on the backside here that helps tighten it down. It's not going anywhere. That bolt's not backing out, even if you left it a little bit loose. I wish I would have snugged it up a little more before I got this pulley all the way on, which is Loctited into place. I didn't want to have to take it off and redo the Loctite and everything. But that pretty much summarizes all the work we did here to make this the beautiful creature that you see before you. And I'm very excited to get this in the car, even more excited that I'm gonna be able to run AC. In fact, that has taken, well, it's taken up more time in the build, but now I know that as I'm driving through the desert, which I hope to drive this car through the desert at some point, that I'll be able to at least have some measure of comfort while I do that. because I don't know if you've ever driven on really hot days on a car with an engine that makes a lot of heat that you had to do with the windows down. Now, it's fun and the sound is great, but gosh darn it, if you had air conditioning, you would use it. Well, this concludes what I will call the engine dress-up video. Yeah, we started out with jeans and a t-shirt, and now she is in her prom dress and ready to go out dancing. And as good as this looks, that's not what I set out to do with this kit when I got it. I really just wanted to find a way to mount this AC compressor, and this kit from CVF Racing really did the trick. And now I'm going to be able to run AC in the car, which I'm very excited about. I want to point out once again that CVF did not sponsor this video. I just purchased this kit to, like I said, solve this AC compressor mounting problem. It also comes in black. I'll put links to it in the description so you can check it out. Same thing with the valve covers. I didn't get these valve covers because they were pretty. I got these valve covers because of these two breathers here. In fact, I think they use this type on circle track cars. I'm hoping to avoid having to use an oil catch can, but if I still have the same problems with the oil coming out of the top of these, then I'm gonna have to go there next. If I can get away with this, it makes it a lot easier, less to mount inside the engine compartment, all that. Anyway, as stated, I'll put links in the description to all of this stuff so that you can check it out, and as well as additional videos and information. I'm also gonna put a link in the description to EricTheCarGuy.com, which is where I ask you go if you have automotive questions. And if you are subscribed to Eric the Car Guy, I ask you to click the little bell icon so that you're notified when I post new videos. Normally I post them on Fridays, but sometimes I sprinkle them out throughout the week. So it'd be nice to know when that happens, right? I close each of my videos with be safe, have fun, stay dirty. Thank you again for watching, and I'll see you next time. Inks. I'll just let the outro do it.